Okay, another lap here. Same location as yesterday. Exercise thing here. Take some weight off it. Bonus. Just oxygen bottle here, so let's have fun with pipe wrench. It's got a... Oh, come on. Just oxygen, but I didn't decompress it. Shouldn't be that much in there. So we're gonna go around and get some of my stainless steel ready. Get that depressed here. This is my drill set. I don't know how much is in there, you can't tell. It's a heavy steel tank. We're just gonna another tub for stainless steel. This one here. I got holes in it already. I don't love bigger holes. Just a minute ago, I saw a hawk or an owl. It was probably a hawk, but it could have been an owl too. It was flying that way and crows are chasing it, and he had a huge rat in his mouth. You can see the big long tail. I was happy about that. I think he got it around here somewhere. So we want pest control. Free pest control. Standing water. all adds up. Okay, got 2 feet containers now. Okay, so that's that. So hopefully the tank's drained by now. I still hear air. I could be full, who knows? Don't know. Can't tell. Oof. You're pretty tight. Okay, let me just grab my tools this way. I'll let it drain because I don't know exactly what's in it. Could sit there for 10 minutes or more. Hold on. I opened the valve. Also, should be a lot faster now. We'll strip a couple of things here, fill the bin up and a few things. Still film recording. Okay, we can deal with this here. That. Thank you. Yeah. Could be stainless. Here. Okay, it's ready. Make less noise because of holding, but sometimes, you know, hammer works the best. It's moving up here. Returning. We've got stainless there. Drop the other one somewhere here. So now we have just the two here. Cast. And then we have this one here. It's aluminum here. Just gonna cut around it. Aluminum old sheet. Okay, stainless. Stainless. Okay, that was good. They say you go out there and stuff filter, you're lucky. There, so I already have 30, 40 pounds aluminum when I add all this up. want to find it because it's brass. It's heavy too. Right there, brass. I don't know how this tool works. Any input? Has it been broken? I don't know. Whatever he does. Okay, so. A little bit lucky in the stainless. This one's so rusty. It's an actual Torx too. So, let's see if we can find it. So the screwdriver I have might work. It works. So rusted, but it fits in good, the Torx, so I'm lucky. Oh, there it is. Oh, there's always one that's jammed. These ones we have to. Okay. These ones here. Not really sure. So rusty. Thank you. Well, this one here, let's grind it. This is too rusty. This one. Well, I usually cut it. This one I'll leave for now. Okay, hold on. Cut the end off here. It's actually pretty heavy stuff. Curious about these things here. Might be brass, which I'm hoping. It's brass. It's heavy. Yes. You can tell when it's heavy. Got some wood. So I scored yesterday. Look at that. People gave it up, didn't know what it was. I love it. free browse. At least the 3 pounds of brass, I would think, close to 3 pounds. But I love it. I don't know if this is stainless here. I'm trying to get my magnet, but let me get this bike out of here. These bottles. Made in my console, spare one, somewhere in here. Okay. Yeah, it's stainless. That's what I thought. So what's involved on taking that off? They put a hammer. Just a hammer. Just a hammer. It was good, a little bit of stainless steel. The barbecue actually was good, payday, not bad. Steel. We're just gonna steal a little bit way like that. Aluminum socket, so I mean I could actually almost a fail. And so pot metal thing. It was a halogen kind of light. Stuff here. So we got a little bit of some kind of pot metal here. Brass even too. This thing could be brass. I think it's brass. So the light's out. It's probably pot metal. I'm gonna grind it. White inside. Goes with that. Couple screws here. Aluminum wire. Stripped. Another one. Jammed. Yeah, so this stuff heavy steel. Putting HMS. Why it has to be so much tighter. Okay. You hold on. Wow. Tight. Stand in case of flies. So never can tell. Ooh, that's heavy. That's just a pound. Well, maybe not a pound, but it could be a pound. It's heavy stuff. Brass. 0.6 of a pound. Half, just over half. Okay, this one's ready. HMS. Someone's dead. There's no air. A bigger pipe wrench somewhere. So good thing is we got I don't know, about almost $2 in brass and plus a tank. HMS with the tank weight. Almost 9 pounds. That's like $3 of scrap. Well, this is kind of stuff you don't take because it's compressed air and are people worried. So, well, this has an Allen key. The gas chamber. I did buy some Allen keys. Let's put it to the test. It almost looks like it might not be the right ones. So it looks a little too big. I don't know. Not sure what's going on here. The next step is, if you can't take that off, Kath's got a crit. Well, here's a crescent wrench here. We'll open the valve, the main valve, see if there's any air in it. We'll investigate. I think it's totally open. Yeah, it's already opened, full. Well, someone drained it before they threw it away, that's what I'm thinking. Looks like a brand new. Let's look at what it says here. Oxygen, compressed oxygen, okay. So I'll double check. Still tough. Okay. coming. I think this was just recently refilled, serviced Magnaflux tank. Okay. There it is. See, three valves. Make a better accurate reading with three. 2.1 pounds, see? Unless one valve is heavier than the other. 0.7. 0.6. 0.7. So two or 0.7. So that's good. Now hold on. I'd like to dump GHMS tomorrow, but we'll see. See how it goes. Okay, that's it for lead. Oh, I'll get two more. Okay, I'll do it off camera, but two more. Okay. Okay, I got a brass one here. This might be just epoxied in there. I don't think it's threaded in there, but. To see where what a bounty was. So this is a brass, 1 pound, no? 0.7 of a pound. And here's lead. This is one joint. It's just over half. This comes out as clean lead category. Should be well. 30, maybe it could be 50 cents, 60 cents, I don't know. It's about 10 pounds, 9.8, but it'll come up at 10. So that's the lead I have here. But I have now, I have some toilet rings and some other lead things. Make sure you wear gloves dealing with lead. Lead goes in your skin, stays in your tissue, body tissues, hard to get rid of. So that's lead. I was gonna do something else here. What else would I do? Okay, back to the other side now. Okay, hold on. Might be able to unscrew it. I thought it was stainless. So, oh, I gotta find it. So I had two of these and one disappeared. I don't know where it went. I don't think I processed it. I can't remember. I don't think so, but maybe I did. A nice piece of brass here. To the toilets. You do your toilets in the house. Let's see that one. Okay, nice brass here. Toilet ring. So I thought I had, I thought I had another one, which is weird. I'm sure I had another one. Tape's gonna be tough to get off. Wax on my shoes. Toilet wax. I'm thinking this one I might have to grind it or something. I'm not cutting lead, I'm just cutting plastic. It actually goes in really deep. There it is. Toilet bowl. It's pretty heavy. So I'll probably get docked for this tape here, but I don't think it's gonna come off that easy. I mean, it's just, I can separate it. Still clean lead, but it's got a little bit of tape. Not gonna fool with it. Constant cleaning here, otherwise stuff starts rolling around all the time. I don't really like checker plate too much. Looks nice, but okay, hold on for a minute. I'm gonna charge my GoPro a bit. I'm gonna cut that up maybe. Maybe I'll cut up now and then take a small break. just so it's easier to get in the bin. All the good stuff's taken off of it. Okay, we're gonna clean up a little stuff around here. We'll take the HMS over there. Clean up that steel too. Okay, hold on. Here we got a smokehouse here on a strip. There. So this one looks like it's riveted together with steel. So I have like little bits here. Dry, drill this out and see what happens. What I can drill out. All the crap. So it might be worth more. Dirty, hard to say, but still clean. I want to clean it anyways. Thank you. Okay. I find if I just cut this here, it comes out more easier. Pretty clean, pretty fast. Here, let me weigh this and see how much.
Hold on.
This one weighs 8 pounds. Weight is 8 pounds. Okay, so you take the front end off, right? Tray. So you could probably salvage this, but then the lid is stuck to it and it's got screws. Flathead screws. Okay, let's check the weight. So 8 pounds dirty, so times, so we'll calculate exactly. Price down on this aluminum now, a little bit lower. So we're gonna say I think it's 0.36 times 8, 288, and it's, 7, I think. $310. So $310 for this, besides $288. There's a little bit of tin, not much, but so we got 3 5 pounds of tin, so 8 cents, 40. So I'm getting 40 cents plus this, so 350, 288, so I made about 60 cents. 60 cents, I guess, for nothing. Makes a good video, but shows you like some things, you know, you don't really gain a lot, but still for 5 minutes work, or no, it wasn't 5 minutes, it was quick, but it just kind of educate you. When you start stripping things, you want to wonder if it's worth it or not, but it's okay. I don't mind stripping stuff like that. Okay, let me clean my table here and we'll do one or two more things and that's it. I have a board here. I may strip this completely or I might not, just because I kind of want to get this battery out and see what happens. And I don't think I have enough video left or battery. Oh, look at that. Plastic. I thought it was going to be better than plastic. These ports here are going to be brass, dirty brass at least. All electronics in this hoverboard. It's amazing. A lot of stuff I can strip. Nice circuit board there. Amazing how much circuitry is in this stuff. Oh, it's got all MOSFETs here. All on the outside. That's what I was taking off. Sure about those wheels. It's aluminum. That's out. Okay, now I see what's going on here. This one's a Torx. Okay. Okay, so these are mortars here. There's a mortar inside those things. That's a battery, but this goes to recycle center. This is going to be lithium ion. Lithium ion, so something like that. I don't want in the garage. Okay, so here is going to be a mortar. So I've stripped on these before, it's too hard to strip. I usually just sell these the way they are. But I'm just gonna sell this just dirty aluminum. The mortar in there, but it's pretty hard to strip. I mean, you probably can, but patience. So that's your cast. More of the this plastic's not coming off. There's one screw here. At least here's a lot of screws. There's a ring here. You need a ring tool. Let's see if I can just grind it. So, there's bushing here and stuff. I mean, it's not 100% clean yet, but there's another ring here on that side. One's really hard. HMS. It's still got a sleeve in this one here. So let's keep here. Let me go to the big vise here, hold on. It's exactly gonna break it. I was hoping this would break out as I hit it, but it didn't. Okay, so we're gonna use a punch, hopefully. Okay, let's see, I'll go. Huh, looks like brass. I think I got a piece of brass here, or copper even. Oh no, looks plated. Wow. Clean pin. You can always go like this. See that, guys? Claw the hammer. I was watching some people on YouTube and they're fighting the chisel. A little pry bar, just use the hammer. Hammer's your best friend. Well, that's hoverboard, not much aluminum, but well, let's just weigh it. This is, I think some have top and bottom aluminum, but this is just at the bottom. So we'll just see. $2.3, a couple dollars there. Sometimes they have a lead acid battery. This one is lithium ion, which is no value to us. Not right now, maybe later. And all these nuts and bolts is hardware. It's going to be HMS. The circuit boards here. They do have IC chips and stuff. Circuit board there. Transistors there. MOSFETs. Got copper on here too. This one will. Okay, plastic. And these being dirty, it's worth taking out. The nut will be probably brass, maybe. Take a look at this wheel again. I think I'm gonna put electric motor. Cut the tire off. I'll show you. Okay, this tire. Looks like a recycle. It's almost like a sealed hub, but it should come off. Okay, so we'll take this knock, that'll be cast. So we can't break this apart, but I can actually grind it. Let's see, maybe we can do something here. Since we're here. It's actually a battery, it's got magnets, made neck and mortar. I stripped one before. Now we got a mortar for sure. It just felt the way it is because, you know, it'd be tough to strip that. So now we have to knock all the magnets off, which wasn't that hard because I did it before. If I remember correct, the magnets are sticking to steel, so this is half steel, that's why I don't strip it, now I remember. I have to double check because the last one I had was steel here, it doesn't feel like it here. It was a steel rim fused in there. It doesn't look fused. So it might be okay. This makes you wonder what's holding it there. Well, I might be able to strip it. Your magnet's tough. See, it's sticking to something here still. I think there's a little band in there. Sticking to a band, so why would it be sticking there? Yeah, see that? It's just a little band. You can't clean it. I can't physically clean it, but see that right there? That's why I never clean these. But I can take leaks like a separate mortar, get dirty aluminum, and get mortar price. So, this bearing fell out, so I can at least get some metal for that cast. I can knock the bearing out of here. Just grind the same thing again. Okay, I think that's it for the video, guys. I'm gonna call it here. We're just gonna get another blade here and grind this so I can get this one done the same way. Just sell the other thing dirty. With electric mortar, I'll get a little more money compared to the other one. We'll get blades right here. Compared to the other one. I only stripped one or two before. I don't strip very many of these, but just started getting a lot of these. Usually these had a other kind of battery. So a lead battery before. Lacking power or something. Not completely cut on the end here. See, that's the buckle. Okay. This is one. Okay, electric motor there. And dirty aluminum here. Okay guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Have a great day. Thanks for watching.